Today, guys, we're going to be working in Adobe After Effects, and I'm going to show you how to actually animate a logo in the exact way you can see on screen. Now, I've actually enlisted the help of someone to help me with these After Effects tutorials, because I am quite a noob when it comes to this software. But if you do want to see more After Effects tutorials heading into the future, do please let me know. So firstly, we want to have our logo as a vector, of course, and I predominantly use Adobe Illustrator. And it's actually a good idea to have all of the individual parts of the logo broken up so we can work with them in After Effects really easily. And so if you have text, you want to outline the text and then just, you know, break up each individual letter from your text. And of course, an easy way to do that is to work in the layers panel. And it's going to really help if you leave lines like the square here as a stroke object and not outlined or expanded. So you can import your projects by either coming up to File and then Import, and there's actually the keyboard shortcut. Or alternatively, you simply can just double click this box here. But when you do import your project, it's important to actually list the import as Composition Retain Layer Sizes. And that's just going to import the design in individual layers like we mentioned earlier. That's effectively created a composition, and we need to double click that composition to enter into it. Oh, and a quick reminder, to actually change the duration of your composition, come up to Composition, and then also Composition Settings, and you can actually change the duration here. And we're going to be working on a 5-second render today. One interesting workflow in After Effects is to actually get rid of the data files linking back to Illustrator, because this can actually confuse things. So instead, we're going to actually change the objects to shapes within After Effects. So if we come down to here, we can press Ctrl A, and that's going to highlight all of these Illustrator data objects down here. And then we're going to right click and create shapes from vector layers. What that has done is effectively change all of the Illustrator objects into paths within After Effects. If you just click here and drag down a tiny bit, we can rearrange things like so. And then we can just click and drag to highlight all of the Illustrator objects and then just remove them. So now we're working with shapes completely within After Effects. And to prove this, if you zoom in here on the O, it's actually a shape and we can edit it like so in After Effects. Like in Adobe Illustrator, it can be annoying when you have background layers that just move around when you click them by accident. So what we can do is we can lock that background layer here as you would in any Adobe software. And that's now locked down nicely. In today's animation, we're not going to actually animate individual letters, because for this animation I'm working on, it might not look too great. So we're going to group things together. So highlight all of the SAT, right click, and then go to pre-compose. And we're going to give it a relevant name like SAT so we can quickly identify what is in that group. And I'm going to do the same thing again for the bottom ROI. Now with the SAT and the ROI, if we click this box here, this is going to be continuous rasterize, and we actually have a bounding box appearing now. Switched off, you can see the complete area, which is not going to be too intuitive. And if we actually turn that off as well, when we scale things, it's not vectorized to infinite as you would with, you know, Adobe Illustrator. With it turned off, we have that kind of fuzzy pixelated look that you would expect in Photoshop. We're going to start by animating the SAT in today's video. And so to start doing that, I'm going to move to 2 seconds in my timeline, which is where most of the animation is going to start to end, if that makes sense. And so I highlight both of the layers I want to animate, this being the 2 layers of text, and then press P on your keyboard, P for Peter. Because both layers are highlighted, and when we click the stopwatch icon, it's actually going to affect both layers at the same time. And at the 2-second mark, this is where I want the SAT and the ORI to finish in this position here. Anything before that is going to be the animation. So I'm now going to drag them back to the beginning of the timeline. And if I drag the SAT and the ORI outwards, you will see how things animate back to that starting point at 2 seconds. And that is pretty linear and pretty boring, as you can see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight all of the keyframes and then press F9 on the keyboard, and then come up here to the graph editor. If you do see this, however, you need to make sure you are in the speed graph, so make sure you've got that checked. And again, highlight all of the keyframes, and then I'm going to bring the arms inwards to the center. And as you can see, when we preview the animation now, it kind of isn't a linear, steady progress. It's got some kind of character to it now. We're now going to create a mat for the SAT and the Ori text. So you need to make any color rectangle you want and drag it over the stroked rectangle. We don't want it any larger or any smaller than the stroked rectangle. And then we're going to name this mat. I'm then going to pick whip it to the original rectangle outline. And then, as you can see, when I move things, they are in unison. That's how pick whip works. It's kind of linking them together. Now I'm going to hide the mat because you'll see when we go to the effects preset window and set mat, when I actually move things, it's kind of knocked out. So the mat is acting like a kind of a mask and revealing the animation whenever it comes into that space. And then you simply copy that onto the Ori and we get the same effect for that text too. Simply click the layer that you want to copy, press Command or Control C, and then paste it onto the layer with Command or Control V. We're now going to animate a square, and so in the drop down of the square, press Add and then Trim Pass. Once you do select Trim Pass, this window will come up. And we're going to go back to that 2 second mark, and you will notice that the stopwatch says end, and then drag it right back to the beginning again. And of course, we've got another very generic kind of animation that's just filling in the stroke from 0 seconds up to 2 seconds. And then for this square animation, highlight all of the frames again, right click and go down to Easy Ease. Or we can do the F9 on the keyboard again, and also then come into this section and do what we did before, but with the square. There are different ways to do this, but this is one easy and a very quick way to be doing this. And as you can see, the preview is looking pretty neat already. And if I drop down a square again, you can see where there's an offset option here. Click this one at the start, and then at the end, click another keyframe, and then just make it do one iteration as in 1 times, 1x. And do the same thing again, using the F9 or coming up to the graph here. And that's just going to make the stroke move along as it's doing the animation. And now we're going to rotate the actual rectangle box as it animates. So at the start, add a keyframe, then move to 2 seconds, and then add a rotation of 180 degrees. And again, you've got that generic, boring, kind of steady animated sequence. And as we did before, highlight all of the keyframes with F9, and then edit things again to make it more interesting. There are plugins for this kind of stuff, but this is how you do it manually, and it's always good to know, of course. We're now going to tidy things up before we move on to the next parts, and we're going to group all of the layers apart from the background layer. So click, hold down shift, and then click to highlight everything, and then right click and hit pre-compose. We're going to add some flashy different color effects to our animation. This is all about adding more style in this section. And so to do this, firstly unlock the background, click on the logo top layer, which is our animation, come over here and type in fill. If you double click that, it's going to default to red, but we can then edit the color here. So I'm going to change it to white from the default red, and I want to add a fill onto both of the two layers, and you need to make sure it's the same color as it currently is, and you will soon see why. So you basically need to add a fill effect to each layer so you can animate them properly. Add fills to both layers that you want animating and color them to their current color. This is your starting point. And then scrub to a frame later and change the colors to the alternative color. This will give you the flash. Then copy and paste the first frame to one frame after and then go back to the original. We're then going to set a keyframe for both of these in the drop down, and you do that by clicking like so. And then if we nudge over one frame, we can then reverse the colors with this arrow icon. So we're then going to just simply change around the black to the white and the white to the black. And then we can actually copy the keyframe and it will make a little flash like so. And I'm actually going to duplicate this flash twice, and you can do that by Command C and then Command V, or Control C and Control V. You can actually drag out the keyframes like so to increase the amount of time spent on the flash. Just having three keyframes for a flash would only mean it will show for one frame. If you add another flash frame and then spread it out, it will last longer. And again, I'm just duplicating the flash over to the right here. You most likely do a lot of playing around with your flashes until you feel like it fits your animation properly. We're now going to change the scale of the logo, and it's going to be starting at around 20% larger and then ending up in this size position now. But first we're going to tidy up the layers here, so press Ctrl A to select everything, and then press U on your keyboard, and voila, it collapses everything so it keeps things just nice and neat. So click on the logo layer because that's what we want to scale, press S on the keyboard, and that's going to bring up the scale property. And then press the stopwatch here at the beginning, and then press it on the 2 second mark when everything ends in our animation. And then we go back to the start and press 120 in the scale. As the animation plays out, the logo kind of scales down a tiny bit. It just adds more intrigue, you know, to the design. And of course, like we've done before, highlight all layers and then come into a keyframe assistant and easy ease. And bringing out those arms to the center. But the flashes are not in line with each other, which is pretty important to get right, and I'm going to bring them back a bit as well. And the scale down isn't too obvious, so I'm going to change that to 175%. And I do feel like these keyframes aren't in time properly, so select them all, and then press Shift-Alt, and then press the left-right button. And that's going to shift them 10 keyframes to left or right. Now that's looking pretty good, as I said, but we can add an extra little bit onto the end of this animation. We're going to actually add in a line stroke that's going to lie over the original stroke. So we're going to duplicate this layer of the actual square, and that's just Command or Control D. And on the duplication, we're going to get rid of these properties. And we're going to pick whip this one here so they're kind of connected, as we said earlier, with the mat. So essentially, we now have two layers doing the same thing, and you won't even be able to tell the difference that there are two different layers. We're going to rename this one small, and we're going to go into it, and you can resize it up here. But to go even further, we can come into the, you know, the smaller one here, and then come into the stroke drop-down menu within it, and then see in the dashes section, we can add the dashes. If you press it once, we can't actually see the gap, so you need to press it twice to bring up the gap option as well. And then we can control the distance between each dash. Like in Illustrator, it's the same kind of principle when working with stroke dashes. And of course, again, come up here to change the stroke weight. And as before, press Ctrl A and then also U to collapse everything in your layers window. And there we have the animation. And we're going to go back to the main composition. And here we go, it's all come together pretty well. And yeah, this was a first After Effects design tutorial on my channel. But if you'd like to see some more broken down tutorials on tips or different parts of After Effects and how to get into After Effects, do let me know down below. But of course, until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.